Welcome to a lesson on writing numbers of different bases in base 10. For example, in our base 10 system, let's consider the number 4,321. We can indicate base 10 using this notation here with a subscript of 10. This becomes important when working with different bases. Because we're so familiar with the base 10 system, we know this 4 represents 4 1,000s. But we can also write 1,000 as 10 to the third. The 3 represents 3 100s, but we can also write 100 as 10 to the second. The 2 represents 2 tens, but we can also write 10 as 10 to the first. And then finally the 1 represents 1 1, but we can write 1 as 10 to the zero. Notice how we can find the indicated place value by taking the base and raising it to an integer power. So we could write 4,321 as 4 times 10 to the third plus 3 times 10 squared plus 2 times 10 to the first plus 1 times 10 to the zero. If we expand this, we do get 4,321 in base 10. But now let's adopt a base 5 system. The only modern digits we need for base 5 would be 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now let's consider 4, 3, 2, 1 in base 5. Let's first take a moment and determine each place value. Remember, we can find place values by starting with 5, raising it to the 0 power, which we see here, which gives us the 1s. Now if we increase the exponent by 1, 5 to the first would give us the 5's place value, 5 to the second would give us the 25's place value, 5 to the third would give us the 125's place value, and so on. So if we wanted to write this base 5 number in base 10, we can do so using each particular place value. This 4 represents 4 5 to the thirds, or 4 125's. This 3 represents 3 5 to the seconds, or 3 25's. This 2 represents 2 5 to the first, or just 2 5's. And then finally, this 1 represents 1 5 to the 0, or 1 1. So simplifying the right side, notice how we end up with 586 base 10. We have 500 plus 75 plus 10 plus 1. So 4, 3, 2, 1 in base 5 is equal to 586 in base 10. Let's look at some more examples. We want to convert the base 4 number 10321 to base 10. So I think it's always helpful to start with the base, which in this case is 4, and start with 4 to the 0, which we see here, work our way left, increasing the exponent on 4 by 1 each time. So we have 4 to the 0, 4 to the first, 4 to the second, 4 to the third, and 4 to the fourth. Notice here we have 5 place values, the same as our number. So to convert this to base 10, we can say that 10321 base 4 would be equal to, we have this 1 indicates 1256, so we have 1 times 256 plus, we have a 0 in the 4 to the third, or 64 place value. Let's go ahead and put that in there. We'd have 0 times 4 to the third, or 64, plus we have a 3 in the 4 to the second, or 16 place value. So we have 3 times 16, plus we have a 2 in the 4 to the ones place value, or just 4's place value. So we have 2 times 4, plus we have a 1 in the 1's place value, so we have 1 times 1. And now we'll simplify to get our base 10 number. We have 256 plus 0 plus 48 plus 8 plus 1, which gives us 313, and this would be base 10. So we found that 10321 base 4 equals 313 in base 10. Let's take a look at one more example. Let's convert the base 7 number 5624 to base 10. So we have 7 to the 0, 7 to the 1, 7 to the 2nd, 7 to the 3rd, and 7 to the 4th. Because our number only has 4 digits, we only need these 4 place values. So 5624 in base 7 is equal to 5 times, this would be the 7 to the 3rd place value, or the 343's place value, plus 6 times, this would be 7 to the 2nd place value, or the 49's place value, plus 2 times 7 to the 1st, or 7, plus 4 times, this is the 1's place value, and now we'll simplify. 5 times 343 is 1,715, plus 6 times 49 is 294, plus 14 plus 4 gives us 2,027. This would be base 10. So again, we can say that 5624 base 7 is equal to 2027 in base 10. And we'll go ahead and stop here. I hope you found this helpful.